horse right here, the name is Paul Revere. And here's a guy that says if the weather's clear, can do, can do. This guy says the horse can do. If he says the horse can do, can do. Rained last night, likes mud. This gas means the horse likes mud. This gas means the horse likes mud. Likes mud. Likes mud. I tell you, Paul Revere, now this is Paul Revere. From a handicapper that's real sincere.
I care about it, time is on the morning line. The guy says the horse can
on.
Well, tell them loaded and looking for action. It's quite 5,000 potatoes.
5,000 bucks?
Where did you acquire it?
I collected a reward from my father.
Everyone's looking for action. I wish Nathan finds them.
Why, Lieutenant Brannigan, Mr. Southstreet. It is Lieutenant Brannigan of the New York Police Department.
A pleasure.
Neither of you guys say Nathan from Detroit.
Which Nathan Detroit is that?
I mean, the Nathan Detroit who's been running a floating crap game around here. You can tell him for me. I know he's running around trying to find a spot.
Hi, Nathan.
Fellas, I'm having terrible trouble. Everyone's scared on account of lousy Brannigan and I.
Something wrong, Mr. Detroit.
Oh, hello, Lieutenant. I hope you don't think I was talking about you. There are other lousy Brannigans.
Detroit, I imagine you're having trouble finding a place for your crap game.
Well, the heat is on, as you must know from the fact that you now have to live off of your salary.
Nathan, did you find a place for the game yet?
I was just over at the Biltmore Garage. Joey says he might take a chance and let me use the place. If I give him $1,000.
$1,000?
In cash.
Nathan, can't you do anything?
What can I do? I'm broke. I couldn't even get Adelaide a present today. You guys know what today is? It's mine and Adelaide's 14th anniversary. We've been engaged for 14 years.
Nathan, concentrate on the game. The town's up to here with hot plays. The Greeks in town.
Brandy bottle pates.
I know, I can make a fortune. But where can I have the game?
The Biltmore Garage, Monte Carlo.
Harvard School 84. There's a stocking behind McCloskey's bar.
But Mrs. McCloskey ain't a good scout.
And things being how they are, the back of the police station is out.
So the Biltmore Garage is the spot. But the 1,000 bucks we ain't got.
Why is good old reliable Nathan Detroit?
If you're looking for action, he'll furnish the spot. Even when the heat is on, he's never too hot. Not for good old reliable Nathan, for it's always just a short walk to the oldest established brilliant.
How much strudel?
What do you want to know for?
Just find out. Now beat it. Here comes Adelaide. She finds out a Randy crack game. She'll never set foot on me again.
Girls? Hello, Nathan, darling.
Adelaide, pigeon.
You go ahead, girls. Order me a tuna fish on rye and a chocolate sundae with tomato ketchup and mayonnaise.
Okay, Adelaide.
We gotta get back to the hot box.
Is it over?
Yeah. That slave driver, Charlie, he's been working us all day. Finally, I says to him, look, Charlie, I'm starving. I gotta get out of here and get something to eat. And he says, you don't want to eat. You just want to sneak out and meet that cheap bum, Nathan Detroit.
So what did you say to him?
I told him. I says, I'll meet whoever I want. Nathan, happy anniversary.
A present for me?
I hope you like it.
A belt.
Read the card.
She'll get you sweet and so is jelly, so put this belt around your belly.
That's so sweet.
Look, honey, about your present, I didn't get one. I'm sorry.
That's okay. I kind of like it when you forget to give me presents. It makes it feel like we're married.
Don't worry, honey. One of these days I'll be in the money, and you'll have more mink than a mink.
Nathan, darling, I can do without anything. Just so long as you don't start running the crap game again.
Crap game! What an absurd thought.
Yesterday, Minnie sold 1,200 cheesecake and 1,500 strudel.
Well, strudel and cheesecake. That's great.
Nathan, what is this?
Nothing. Look, honey, I'm expecting a fellow and I know you're hungry.
Nathan, are you trying to get rid of me?
No, I just don't want your sandwich to get soggy, that's all. Fellas?
Nathan, you old promoter, you!
Scott Masterson, how goes it? You gonna be in town long?
No, I'm flying to Havana tomorrow.
Havana?
Yeah, there's lots of good action down there. You wanna come with me?
Nah, I got things to do. Tell me, Scott, you hungry? Maybe we can run with Mindy's, get a piece of cheesecake or a strudel or something.
No, I think I'll go get the late results.
But you will admit, Mindy has the best cheesecake in this country.
Yes, I am quite partial to Mindy's cheesecake.
Oh wait, and yet there's some people who prefer Mindy's strudel. Offhand, which do you think he sells more of, the cheesecake or the strudel?
Well, if everybody's like I am, I'd say that he sells much more cheesecake than strudel.
All right, for how much?
Huh?
I am willing to bet you $1,000 that yesterday, Mindy sold more strudel than cheesecake.
Nathan, let me tell you a little story.
Oh.
When I was a young man about to go out into the world, my father said to me a very valuable thing. Son, the old guy says, One of these days in your travels, you're gonna come across a guy with a brand new deck of cards who will offer to bet you that he can make the Jack of Spades jump out of the deck and squirt cider in you. But son, do not bet this man, because sure as you are standing there, you will end up with an ear full of cider. Now, Nathan, I do not claim that you've been clocking Minnie's cheesecake.
You don't think that.
However, if you're really looking for some action, I'm willing to bet you the same thousand that you do not know the color of the necktie you have on right now. Well?
No bet. Blue. What a crazy color.
We took Adelaide to the drugstore, and she said for you to be sure to pick her up after the show at the Hot Box, and don't be late.
Yes, dear. I mean, yes.
Yes, dear. That is husband talk if I ever heard it. Nathan, you are trapped, and Adelaide, you have a doll that is most difficult to unload.
But I don't want to unload her, Sky. I love Adelaide. And a guy without a doll? Well, a doll's a necessity.
Nathan, I'm not trying to put the rap on dolls. I'm just saying, figuring weight for age. All dolls are the same.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Then how come you ain't got a doll? How come you fly in the van alone without one tomorrow?
Well, I like to travel light. However, if I wish to take a doll to Havana, there's a large assortment available.
Real.
Yeah.
Well, not real. I just
like any doll. You name it.
Any doll. And I name it. You bet on that. You bet the thousand if I name the doll, you will take her to Havana with you tomorrow?
You got a bet.
All right.
Do you take sinners here?
Indeed we do. Didn't I see you a little while ago on Broadway?
Well, possibly. I have been wandering around trying to gather up the courage to come here.
Here are two of our pamphlets. They will give you a good deal of comfort.
Thank you.
And we're holding a midnight prayer meeting on Thursday, which I'm sure you'll wish to attend.
I'm sure, Miss Sarah.
How do you know my name?
Allow me to introduce myself. Sky Masterson. Look, I think it's wonderful to see such a pretty, nice-looking lady such as yourself sacrificing for the sake of others.
Here's another pamphlet that I think you should read.
Thanks. Of course, I will need a lot of personal help from you.
I'll be speaking at the Thursday prayer meeting.
I need private lessons. Why don't we have dinner or something?
I think not. Tell me, Mr. Masterson, why are you here?
I told you I'm a sinner.
You're lying.
Lying's a sin? Look, I'm a big sinner. If you get me, it's 8 to 5. The others will follow. Why don't you let me help you? I bet I can fill this place up with sinners.
I don't bet.
Well, then why don't I make you a proposition? When's this big meeting of yours? Thursday? I will guarantee to fill this mission up with a 12 genuine sinners.
And what's my end of the bargain?
Have dinner with you.
Why do you want to have dinner with me?
I'm hungry.
What's this?
Sky Masterson's Market. I owe you 12 sinners. If you don't think it's good, ask anybody in town. Look, I'll pick you up at noon tomorrow for dinner.
At noon?
Well, yes, it will take us some time to get there.
To get where?
El Cafe Cubana, Havana.
Havana?
Where else do you want to eat? Howard Johnson's? Look, the plane gets us there 5 hours there and back, and the food is great.
Please, go away.
Somewhere in the world, there must be a guy who appeals to the sergeant. I wonder what this guy will be like.
He will not be a gambler.
I'm not interested in what he will not be. I'm interested in what he will be.
Don't worry.
By the two. how a gambler feels about the big heart club.
No.
Well, I'll tell you.
It's a wedding veil. I've had it for 3 years.
3 years. I won't show it to you because it's bad luck. Would you like to see it?
It's bad luck.
So you see, Nathan, darling, I got the veil. All we need now is our license and blood tests.
What?
Our blood test. It's a law.
What a city. First they closed my crap game, now they want to open up my veins.
Nathan, you're not planning on running the crap game again, are you?
Adelaide, how could you say such a thing? Why do you think I gave up the crap game in the first place? It's because I love you, and I want the two of us to be the happiest married couple in the entire world.
You! I'm all dated up tomorrow with Society Max, and he breaks it on account of your dopey crap game. Honest, Adelaide, I pity you.
Adelaide, look, I'm down on my knees.
Oh, get up. It reminds me of your crap game.
Look, you're getting yourself all upset. You and I are going to be all right. After all, we love each other, and we're going to get married.
I don't believe you anymore.
You'll feel better in the morning. Come on, honey. Chin up. Let me see that old smile. That's my girl. Listen, I gotta go. I'll see you tomorrow.
It says here, we have reached on married female, basically insecure.
Nathan has to go and fall in love with his own fiance.
Benny, that is his weakness, and we must be tolerant, because I'm told it is a worldwide weakness.
When you see a guy reach for stars in the sky, you can bet that he's doing it for some doll. Paying all kinds of rent for a flat that can flatten the Taj Mahal. Call it sad, call it funny, but better than even money that the guy's only doing it for some dough.
Come to the meeting tomorrow night and see for yourself.
Well, if I thought the mission had a chance.
General, I personally guarantee you 12 genuine sinners.
Well, hallelujah!
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 You all got your carnations?
Remember, nobody will be let in without they got red carnations. It's like your passport.
Okay, but where's the game?
I'll tell you in a minute. Can I tell the guys that the Biltmore Garage?
No, not yet. Listen, Joey wants his dough first, so you gotta stall him for a while.
But it's 11 o'clock. They won't stick around for much longer.
So sue me.
Detroit, if you do not have no place for your crap game, tell us, and we'll seek elsewhere for entertainment.
Now take it easy there, Harry.
You mean Big Julie from Chicago.
Well, how do you know, Big Julie?
I came here to shoot crap. Let's shoot crap.
Now, Detroit. If there's no captain tonight, Big Julie will be very displeased, and Big Julie does not like to be displeased.
Well, Big Julie, rest assured that when Nathan Detroit promises something,
wow,
you can bet on it that.
Wow.
interesting gathering indeed. The cream of society. Nicely, nicely, Johnson. Betty South Street. Nathan Detroit. Society Max. Liver Lips Louie. What's the occasion, gentlemen?
Well, we were at
the party. Indeed. What kind of a party?
It's a party.
Hi, Gareth. See you tomorrow.
It's a bachelor dinner. Nathan's getting married.
What? That is correct, Lieutenant. It's a bachelor dinner. Nathan's getting married.
Yes, sir.
For he's a jolly good fellow. For he's a jolly good fellow. For he's a jolly good fellow.
Nobody cannot deny.
It was a surprise!
When I saw you standing here with all these fine gentlemen, I never dreamed it was a bachelor's dinner. I thought it was
It's a bachelor's dinner, all right. That's right, a bachelor's dinner.
Just think, after 14 years, I'm finally going to become Mrs. Nathan Detroit. Time certainly does fly.
Tell me, Nathan, when is the happy day?
When will it be, Nathan?
Nathan. These good fellows are nice enough to give you a bachelor's dinner. You should at least tell them the wedding date.
Well, you know how it is, Brannigan. We need time for our license and blood tests and...
You could elope.
What?
You can drive down to the grand old state of Maryland. They'll marry you right away. They don't even ask for a blood test.
Ain't that unhealthy?
Oh, Nathan, let's do it, please!
What the heck?
My congratulations to Nathan. And I can only hope that there is nothing in heredity.
Hey, Charlie, I got so much to do before we elope. You'll be at the hot box tomorrow, right?
I'll have a table reserved to be dressed in whatever you elope in.
Oh, Nathan, I'm so happy!
Bye, honey.
Nathan! You're indeed a lucky fellow, the most beautiful doll indeed. Do you agree with Julie?
Let's your crap.
Nathan, you'd better find a place.
How can I? The money from Sky ain't come yet.
Maybe it won't come. Maybe he took the doll to Havana.
He couldn't. How could he? She couldn't have gone.
Delicious, please.
You all right?
Am I all right? Ask me how do I feel? Ask me now that we're cozy and clinging. Well, all I can say is if I were a bell, I'd be ringing. From the moment we kissed tonight, that's the way I just got to behave. Boy, if I were a lamp, I'd light. And if I were a bed, I'd wait.
I knew this was going to
instance.
Exactly. It was wonderful. Where have you been, Sarah?
Oh, I've been to Cuba.
You're even more tired than I am.
Thank you. What is this?
Canasta, what do you think?
Wait a minute, I'm losing 10 G's.
No one cares.
Someone must have tipped them off. You know, I've seen a lot of strange things in my time, but that's the first time I've ever seen a floating crap game going full blast in a mission.
Crap game?
Sarah, you know I had nothing to do with this, don't you? Sarah.
This wouldn't have happened if I hadn't... I never should have gone with you. It was wrong.
No, it wasn't. You went to save the mission.
Did I?
Well, I'll at least see you tomorrow.
Everyone is welcome at the mission.
That's not what I mean.
It's no good, Sky. You said it yourself. It's no good.
What kind of doll are you anyway?
I'm a mission doll.
I thought that each expensive gift should arrange
Sky, did you see Miss Adelaide?
Huh?
I bring a message for her from Nathan.
What's the message?
It's this way. Nathan's aunt in Pittsburgh has suddenly fallen ill with
a rare tropical disease.
Say, that's not bad.
Nicely, where's Nathan?
The crab game is still going on.
Since last night?
Well, Big Julie, being a large loser, does not wish the game to terminate.
Where's the game?
You looking for some action?
No, I'm leaving town tonight, but I do want to talk to some of the guys before I go. I gave my marker to somebody, and I kind of want to clear that up before.
I'll meet you outside.
What about the message?
Oh, Miss Adelaide, Nathan is in Pittsburgh with a rare tropical aunt. Goodbye.
What? Sky, I don't understand. Nathan has to come here tonight. We're eloping to get married.
You know, Nathan, why does it surprise you?
But he promised to change.
Change. Why is it the second you dolls get a guy you like, you take him riding for alterations?
What about you, Matt? Why can't you marry people like normal people do and live lives like people? Have a home with wallpaper and bookends.
Guys like Nathan Detroit, and yeah, Sky Masterson, we don't belong in lives like that. So when dolls like you get mixed up with guys like us, it's no good. See you around.
Will you see Nathan before you go?
Maybe.
Tell him I never want to see him again. Achoo! Have
him
call me here.
Why don't you just get another guy?
Wait till you fall for somebody. You'll find out.
Yeah.
Sky Masterson. He came seeking refuge.
He came seeking me. Did you know that?
I knew that the minute he started picking on you, but I didn't know you'd get stuck on him.
The man I love will not be a gambler.
But if you love him enough, Sarah dear.
I can wish you merry music while you're young.
Nathan, 1,000 against your soul.
Sky, I don't even
even know if I have a soul.
Well, give me the dice. And give me some room. I got a lot more than doll writing on this one. They called you Lady Luck, but there was room for doubt. At times you have a very unladylike way of running out. You're wrong to stay with me. The pickings have been lush. And yet, before this evening is over, you might give me the brush. You might forget your manners. You might refuse to stay. And so the best that I can do is pray. Luck be a lady tonight. Luck be a lady tonight. Luck if you've ever been a lady to begin with. Luck be a lady tonight. Luck let a gentleman see.
Luck let a gentleman see.
How nice
a
day
you can be.
I know the way you meet other guys you've been with. Luck be a lady.
Lady with her fingers. She have a heart, she have a soul.
Oh, 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 oh,
oh, oh,
oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh,
oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh,
out of my
sight. Get out of my sight.
Stick with me, I'm the
fellow
you came in with.
Luck be a lady. Luck be a lady.
Luck be a lady.
Luck
be a
lady. Luck be a lady.
Luck
be a lady. Luck be a lady.
What's the matter
all the time? It's not. Coming down, coming down, coming down, coming down. Right.
Go!
so soon, soon. What can you do?
For Points West tonight, I'm appointing Nathan Detroit Major Domo in my stead. Nathan, anyone who does not conduct themselves according to Hoyle will enter the Sky Masterson personally.
You got it, Sky.
What a remarkable young man.
So remember that, you guys. I'm in charge. Oh, Brother Abernathy, you're nice.
Gentlemen, we are honored tonight. Our meeting will be conducted by the head of our organization, General Cargo.
Wonderful to see our mission graced by the presence of so many evil-looking sinners.
Woo!
Now, who would like to start the ball rolling by giving testimony?
Benny, give testimony.
I know, school bridges.
Come, brothers and sisters, I know it is difficult, but let one of you give testimony to the sin that's in your heart. Anyone?
Eric.
Oh, no.
Harry the horse.
Like this guy was bullying for our souls?
I beg your pardon?
Sky Masterson, who will $1,000 into our souls. That's why we're here.
I don't think I understand.
I do, General. He means that they are only here because Mr. Masterson won the limited dice game.
How wonderful! This whole meeting a result of gambling. It shows how good truly can come out of evil. Sergeant Sarah, you have done remarkable work.
Thank you.
Anybody else?
You.
It's like, this is a mission. We will now hear testimony from Brother Nicely Nicely Johnson. Brother Nicely Nicely Johnson.
Well, it happened to be kind of funny. Like a dream. That's it, a dream.
Tell us, in your own words.
I dreamed last night I got on the boat to heaven, and by some chance I had thrown my dice along, and there I stood, and I hollered, "Someone fade me," but the passengers, they know right from wrong. For the people all said, sit down, you're on the boat."
The people all said, sit down. Sit down, you're on the boat.
And the devil will drag you under by the sharp lapel of your checkered coat. Sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down.
Sit down, you're on the boat.
And as I laughed at those passengers to heaven, ha 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 ha, a great big wave came and washed me overboard. And as I sailed, and I hollered, "Someone save me." That's the moment I woke up. Thank the Lord.
Joey built Boris in prison. While he sang a song in broad daylight about how we were going to have a crap game at his garage.
What?
Man.
You know, whatever happened to Sky?
Who knows?
Haven't seen him in a while.
Brothers and sisters, life is one big trap game, and the devil is using loaded die.
Brother Masterson!
Brother Detroit.
Good to see ya. Do you think that me and Adelaide, that we could get married in remission?
Oh. Certainly. I married Brother Masterson and Sister Sarah. I'm glad to be the same for you.
Thank you.
Congratulations, Nathan. I'll let you wait till 5. You'll be very happy.
What Obadiah means is...
Obadiah?
He wishes you every bit of happiness, and so do I.
Thank you. I'm pretty sure we'll be very happy. We'll have a little home in the country, and Nathan will be sitting there beside me. And
we're
Of course.
course.
The show would not be as good as it was without the help of several amazing people. First and foremost, I would like to thank our director, Marcy Shine. She has done everything for the show, from costuming it to conducting us tonight. And we just wanted to say thank you. Would like to thank our choreographer, Marcy. Samara Grossman, for making us dance as good as we do. And last, but certainly not least, I would like to thank our graduating seniors, two in particular. First, I would like to thank our stage manager, Leo Generoso. Alfaro. This is his last production, and he has been a real